Light and Laws of Reflection. In this chapter, let us learn about eyes, eye disorders, light, and various properties of light. Now, let us know how the various things in the world are visible to us. We can sense the different things in the world with the help of various sense organs like ears, nose, eyes, skin, mouth, etc. The sense of sight is one of the most important senses. We can view the various things in the world like rivers, trees, plants, animals, people, buildings, mountains, books, movies, etc. with the help of eyes. Now let us learn about how the things are made visible to us. Though we all know that we see the world with the help of eyes, we cannot see the objects in the dark. It clearly states that eyes alone cannot see any object. It is only when light from an object enters the eyes that we see the object. The light is either emitted by the object or it is reflected by it. As we all know that mirror changes the direction of light that falls on it. Now, let us find out that in which direction the light falling on the surface of the mirror is reflected. First, let us understand the laws of reflection by performing an activity. Fix a white sheet of paper on a table. Take a comb and close all its openings except one in the middle with a strip of black paper. Hold the comb perpendicular to the sheet of paper. Throw light from a torch through the opening of the comb from one side. We can see a ray of light along the paper on the other side of the comb. Place a strip of plain paper in the path of the light ray. We can observe that after striking the mirror, the ray of light is reflected in another direction and the light ray which strikes any surface is called the incident ray. The ray that comes back from the surface after reflection is known as a reflected ray. Now let us draw lines showing the position of the plane mirror, the incident ray and the reflected ray on the paper and remove the mirror and the comb. Draw a line making an angle of 90 degrees to the line representing the mirror at the point where the incident ray strikes the mirror. This line is known as the normal to the reflecting surface at that point. The angle between the normal and incident ray is called the angle of incidence. The angle between the normal and the reflected ray is known as the angle of reflection. Measure the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection. We can find that the angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. This is known as the law of reflection. Generally, we have a narrow beam of light which is made up of several rays. However, we call a narrow beam of light as ray. Let us perform another activity. Take a sheet of chart paper. Let the sheet project a little beyond the edge of the table. Cut the projecting portion of the sheet in the middle. Take a comb and close all its openings except one in the middle. You can use a strip of black paper for this purpose. Hold the comb perpendicular to the sheet of paper. Throw light from a torch through the opening of the comb from one side. Look at the reflected ray. Make sure that the reflected ray extends to the projected portion of the paper. Bend that part of the projected portion on which the reflected ray falls and bring the paper back to the original. When you bend the paper, you create a plane different from the plane in which the incident ray and the normal lie. Then, you do not see the reflected ray. It indicates that the incident ray, the normal at the point of incidence, and the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. This is another law of reflection.